An Argon turbine power plant with two stages of compression and two stages of expansion has an overall pressure ratio of 16. The argon enters each stage of the compressor at 350 Kelvin and each stage of the turbine at 1300 Kelvin. What is the minimum mass flow rate of argon needed to develop a net power output of 80 megawatts? As always, pause here and try solving this yourself before watching the solution. This is the second example for the regeneration, intercooling, and reheating main lecture, and it uses concepts from the Braden cycle main lecture 2, so make sure you've studied those two lectures before attempting to solve this problem. The links to those 13 and 11 minute lectures respectively, and all the other lectures of the thermo course are found in the description below. Since we want to find the mass flow rate given the net power output, we write an expression that relates the two. We know that the power is equal to the specific work times the mass flow rate, which allows us to solve for the mass flow rate. The net specific work is equal to the work that the turbines produce minus the work that the compressors use. Now, if you haven't studied the previous example, please do so before continuing, because I'm going to use two concepts explained there. The first one is that the work of the two turbines can be simplified as 2 times the work of one, 2 times H5 minus H6. And the work of the two compressors can be simplified as 2 times the work of one, 2 times H2 minus H1. The difference here is that the working fluid is argon, which we know has constant specific heat values Cp and Cv. This means that instead of finding enthalpy values from a table, and using the pressure ratio relationship we labeled as the exact analysis derived in the reference entropy 12-minute lecture, link below, we can use the temperature to pressure relationship of the approximate analysis. This we do so that we calculate the work in terms of the specific heat, Cp, and the temperatures that we find with that relationship. The second concept explained in the previous example is that the pressure ratio P6 over P5 is the square root of P8 over P5, the square root of 1 over 16, or just 1 over 4. And with the same concept, we can conclude that the pressure ratio P2 over P1 is the square root of P4 over P1. We solve for T6 and T2, the two temperatures we don't have yet. We substitute the pressure ratios. We look up Cp and K for argon. We substitute K and the known temperatures, and find T6 and T2. We substitute the temperature values in the specific heat Cp, and we find the net specific work. And finally, we substitute the net specific work we just found and the given net power output in our mass flow rate expression to find the value of the mass flow rate. If you want to check out other examples like this with regeneration, intercooling, and reheating, make sure to check out the links I left down in the description below. You'll also find the links to the other lectures of the thermo course as well as other engineering courses playlists. Thanks for watching!